A function is a reusable code block that will execute only when it's called. To create one, we start inside a class by typing void, followed by the function name, an optional parameter list, and a code block. The void keyword simply says that this method will not return a value. The naming convention for functions is the same as for classes, a descriptive name with each word initially capitalized. Note that all functions in C# must belong to a class, and they are the only place where instructions may be executed. The method here will print out a text message. To call it, we must first create an instance of the MyApp class. We then use the dot operator after the instance name to access its members, which includes the method we just made. The parentheses that follows the method name are used to pass arguments. To do this, we must first add them to the function declaration in the form of a comma-separated list. There can be any number of arguments, and they can have any data types. Just make sure to call the function with the same arguments. To take a variable number of arguments, we can add an array with a params modifier as the last parameter in the list. Any extra parameters of that type that is passed to a method will now automatically be stored in the array. C# doesn't support default parameters. Instead, to achieve this, we use the more powerful approach by declaring the function multiple times with different arguments. This is called method overloading and can for example be seen when using the write method, which has 18 declarations. Functions can also be used to return values. We then replace the void keyword with the data type we want the function to return, and then add the return keyword with an argument to the function's body. The return jump statement will cause the function to immediately exit and return the value to the place where it was called. We can, for example, pass it as an argument to the print method, since the function now evaluates to a string. If we want to, we can also use the return keyword in the void function to exit before the end block is reached. When passing parameters of value type, it's important to note that only a local copy of the variable is passed, so if we change the copy, it will not affect the original variable. For reference data types, on the other hand, C# uses true pass by reference. This means that when we pass a reference type, we can not only change its state, but also replace the entire object and have the change propagate back. We can make a value type be passed by reference by using the ref keyword, both in the caller and method declaration. This will cause the variable to be passed in by reference, and therefore changing it will update the original value. Sometimes we may want to pass an unassigned variable by reference and have it be assigned in the function, but using an unassigned variable will cause the compiler to complain. For this situation, we instead use the out keyword, which does the same as ref, except that the compiler will now allow the unassigned value, and it will force us to actually set the variable in the function.